your name?
Nikki.
Nikki. And Nikki's my neighbor. We don't really see each other that much because we're always like on the go. Have you ever been in an electric car before?
No.
Okay.
Not even any electric car, actually.
None.
No.
Not even a Kia?
Nope.
Okay. So you've never been in a Tesla?
Nope.
So you definitely have never been. This is the first time in an electric Cybertruck.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure.
We've never really discussed this vehicle because we're coming and going. So what was your first impression when you seen this thing parked in front of your condo?
Oh my God. I've only ever seen pictures of them, so it's literally the first one I've ever seen. Right. And then it's way bigger than I thought, shinier than I thought. Yeah. It's just insane. It's crazy.
Way frigidier than you thought?
Yeah. The stainless steel effect.
Yeah.
I really didn't know what they looked like at all, right, other than just seeing some boxy pictures.
So basically this is a dual motor, 600 horsepower, 0 to 60 in 4 seconds, but it also weighs 6,600 pounds. So it's the size of a big truck. The weight of the big truck are 2 cars, but it still is faster than most like Mustangs, IROCs, any fast car supposedly, you know, that hasn't been superly modified. This can eat them up.
And I'm sure you've tested that out by now.
Well, they pull up and rev the motors, and it's just like, I push the throttle down halfway and they're gone. And I'm like, were they racing? And then they pull back. I'm like, were we actually racing? Or is that, you know? So then they go again, and then I really go, and then they're really embarrassed.
Right.
And then usually they just pull off, and I never talk to them again. So, and this isn't even the fastest one. This is the dual motor, which is 600 horsepower. They make a tri motor, which is an extra 20 grand. And instead of 0 to 60 in 4.1, it's 0 to 60 in 2.6. So basically, you can be almost anything but a Tesla.
Wow.
So.
That's crazy.
So what else were you impressed with? I knew we kind of did the brief walk around.
The cooler is my favorite
cooler,
part. That's what I would be using the cooler.
She was like, where'd you get ice so cheap? It's like,
I try to be outside this summer. Wow! Oh my God!
That's 60.
That was nice! That was crazy. I got whiplashed.
And
wow.
This is only 66% charge. When I charge it up to like 80 or 90%, it's even faster.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that would affect
that. It's real punchy.
Yeah! Yeah, it is. That's crazy. Yeah. This is crazy.
So what is besides the ice chest?
That was my favorite part. The margaritas, the bottle opener installed. Yeah. It's kind of just a pull up with the party.
Right, you don't have to, and then the old electric, so basically you can run anything. Do you ever do like parties where you bring food or
you
want to cook things? Or you can actually cook it or bring it or you keep it hot. You don't have to worry about outlets. Even if you're on the beach, it's like, don't worry, I've got hot plates.
And I'm sure no problem getting this on a beach.
Yeah. Sag the tires a little bit, and you can go through any soft sand you want.
No, the water. The water is the craziest
part
that you've told me so far.
I told her about boat mode, and also, too, they're adding features all the time. So it's just like your phone, you plug it in at night, and you wake up, and you have all these new features. Also, a gaming system, so you can play the games with a wireless controller, front or back seat. The new games come out all the time, and eventually I think what's going to happen is this will be the biggest game controller console in the world, because there's already like 4 million of these, and pretty soon they want to build 20 million a year. So the software engineers and the people who write software will basically be writing software for Teslas. So it'll be the biggest draw for the new games in the world, bar none.
So do you buy the games on here, or you just wake up and there's just new games downloaded onto your car?
Yeah, there's just new games. So and new features. So like every time this one is so new that the full self-driving isn't even installed yet.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering about, because you said, oh, in the future, there's going to be...
So this one...
How do you update a car to self-drive without doing anything physically?
Yeah, all the hardware is here. It actually was doing a little bit of it the other day. It was like stop and go traffic. It was going and stopping by itself. I wasn't even aware it could do that.
I was about to ask. Does it just do it without asking you?
Yeah. So
we're in smart car time. Ah! Oh my god! It's crazy.
You gotta, amazing. It's like this thing is so heavy too.
Whenever it first came out, it was all over the internet, and like people were just making fun of how it looked and stuff. And I didn't know it had like any features. I didn't know. I thought it was just like, okay, like people just want to buy something that looks cool and different. Yeah. I didn't know it could do all this.
Honestly,
crap.
When it first unveiled, like I wasn't sure if it was a joke or not. Like they pulled it up on stage, and I'm like, because you know Elon, he like jokes around, and I'm like, are they gonna pull the real truck up on stage? And like nothing happened. It was like, this is it. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. And so I was like waiting, because Tesla kept saying, we're gonna come out with a truck. It's gonna be badass. Like you're gonna love this thing. And then this pulls on stage. I'm just like, wait a minute. I've been waiting all this time for this truck, and it's like a joke. And then when I watched the whole presentation, the bulletproof, the armor glass, the way it could outpull anything, it could outmaneuver anything. It's like having a badass pickup truck that can beat a Ferrari. And I'm just like, that's what I want.
Yeah.
I don't want it, because I'm not
really...
And it's
so smooth.
Yeah, I'm not a car guy, but I like fast cars. Mm. But I'm a truck guy, so I'm like, I have the best of both worlds. I have a really fast truck. That's bulletproof.
How long was it in the works before you finally decided to get it?
I ordered this 4.5 years ago.
What?
So talk about delayed gratification. Like, I am like number one. And then I was number 75,000. And then somehow I skipped over like 70,000 people. Because I was expecting to get it at the end of the year. Because they're only building 75,000 of these this year. So I was like, maybe I'll get it by the end of the year. Because it was on my birthday. Because November 10th is my birthday. And I ordered November 19th. Mm-hmm. So it would have been like 5 years on my birthday. Mm-hmm. So I was like, well, that sounds about right. And then Easter Sunday, like the night before Easter. Since my mom had this Tesla and she doesn't really keep track of it, I was looking through her messages. And it said, your Tesla's ready. I'm like, what? And I'm like, I start scrolling through, and it's like, the Cybertruck is ready. I'm like, so I didn't have, like, any, like, it was just kind of like, boom, it's here.
Well, that's awesome, actually.
And so, and then I was thinking, well, maybe it's a typo or something. It's not right. So then Easter Sunday is like, are you going to pick up your truck today? I'm like, well, I'm meeting with my family. I haven't even got it financed yet, you know? Plus, also, too, when I ordered it, was $50,000. So I was like, man, I've never spent $50,000 on a vehicle. Like, I was kind of hesitant.
Mm.
So then I'm like, well, I'll start saving money, and I'll start buying stock. And then hopefully by the time the truck gets here in 4 years, I'll have enough money to pay for it. So I was buying on margin. I got up to, like, $50,000. And then... he bought Twitter, and then it destroyed the stock.
Yeah.
So the stock is worthless. And then they come out and say, well, since COVID, it went up 20,000, and then also we're adding another 20,000 for Founder Series. So your $50,000 truck is now 100,000, and your stock is worthless.
Oh my God.
So I'm like, timing couldn't have been better. You know? So needless to say, I had to get a loan. And I went to get a loan at ViStar. I'm like, well, I've been with them 30 years. I got perfect credit. I'm making money. I have no debt. Should be no brainer. I go in and talk to the loan officer, and he's like, if you can't get this, I don't know who can, right? So putting all the numbers, I'm waiting, you know, thinking about, man, I'm going to get this truck. He's like, well, they only approved you for $30,000. I'm like, what? I'm like, yeah. So I was kind of discouraged, and I was like, well, I can just get a personal loan for the rest or whatever. And then the loan process was too long.
Yeah.
So I was like, well, Tesla approved me for $50,000. Maybe I can put that with this loan and then just, you know, pay for some cash. And so he's like, well, I called Tesla and they're like, well, your loan has expired because it's been over 30 days. It was like 50 days. I'm like, oh my God. So I'm like, you know what? I said, I believe this is God. If he wants me to have this truck, I'm going to have it. If not, I'm not worried about it. So I just reapplied on Tesla and they gave me one.
Wow.
And it was cheaper than the bank. So it all worked out.
They want you to have those cars.
Yeah, so that's the story.
I mean, this thing is awesome.
It's
crazy.
Yeah, it's like everything I've always wanted when I was a boy.
Really, though, yeah.
It's like a big
I didn't realize how much space was going to be in the back. Like, yeah. It really just is a truck. Like, that's just an actual truck. But
yeah, people argue with me. They're like, that's not a truck. That's an SUV. And I'm like, no, it's a truck.
Open it up.
And so I'll let them have the last word, and then I'll get shown, oh, okay, it is a truck.
It's a truck, yeah.
It looks like an SUV from the side. But,
That's what I thought,
and also, I forgot to tell you, if you hit this button, the whole truck will race, 17 inches. See it? Feel it?
Just the kind of stuff that you wouldn't ever think you would need.
So now we're, like a big truck.
Oh, I feel it now. Wow. All this car wash stuff.
Car wash mode. So you hit a button, it folds the mirrors and seals everything up. So that way,
of course, it does. The car would never want you to do anything yourself.
Yeah. And then you hit this button and tell it to do stuff if you're too lazy to hit that button.
I can't believe that it's an update that makes it self driving and it's not like you have to buy a whole new car for that to work. I would be way too, I don't think I could ever use that. Even if I had it, I'd be way too afraid.
Yeah, I've been using, my mom has the beta package. And also, this is really crazy because before they had programmers, like they were labelers, and they'd say, okay, that's a fire hydrant, that's a dog, that's a cat, that's a bicycle, that's a truck, whatever, trash can, safety cone. They did that for years. And then they're teaching it different scenarios, like, you know, something happens, this is what you do, and it was code after code after code. Well, they figured out that this new, when AI started taking over, they built this new computer called Dojo, and they actually took the top 10% of the best drivers at Tesla, and they started basically using their driving skills and AI, and now they got rid of everything they ever did. Now for the last, 6 or 8 months, the computers and the cars have been teaching themselves how to drive, and they're 10 times better than what they've been using before.
That's crazy. So you can see all the cars around and the lights.
Yeah.
Literally a video game, but we're in real life.
Yeah, that's what the car's seeing, what the computer's seeing.
Wow. I mean, it knows a bike lane is there?
Yeah. It sees better than us because it has 8 cameras all the way around, and it's pure vision, so there's no LiDAR, no nothing, because how people drive, it's all based on vision.
Wow, you can see that person walking! Yeah. That person walking! Yeah. What? It knows this is a semi?
Yeah. Motorcycle.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And so what's happening is there's 4 million of these, so they're basically spitting in information, and then if you're just driving straight, nothing happens. It kicks that information out, and it just does these weird scenarios where, like, if someone walks out in front of you, or someone swerves, or an elephant walks across, it saves all that weird stuff, and it processes it, because any car can drive straight down the road and keep in the lines, you know?
Right.
But the hard part is when unexpected things happen, and since they have such a vast fleet of vehicles, they're so far ahead of everybody. And everybody's still trying to use LiDAR, whereas pure vision is going to be the future because it has to figure things out for itself. Because if you take this car and you place it anywhere in the world it can drive, if you take a car that has GPS modifications and it has to know where everything's at, it's going to basically run people over. If you take a car in Vegas and set it in like Hawaii, it's going to be lost.
Mm.
But this car, any of these Teslas, you can set anywhere in the world. And based on vision, it can decide what to do.
Wow.
So it kind of learns like a baby, like a person.
Yeah.
You know?
It's kind of creepy.
Yeah. And when my mom's car drives, it is so weird because it'll hesitate and it'll do weird stuff just like a person would. Like it's you could see it thinking.
Oh my god.
And it's just like, it's like iRobot type stuff.
Gonna have to get back in for the self-driving whenever you get it installed. Yeah.
Mom's car.
For maybe just around the block.
Yeah.
I'm a little scared of her.
And my daughter's like, Dad, like, let's just like watch a movie or something. I'm like, no, I gotta watch this, make sure this car doesn't do anything weird. Because it's not 100%. It's like say this, the vehicle was like an 18-year-old. So you still have to watch it. It's kind of the driver's ed. But like that's in 6 months, it'll be like something that's like 25. Whatever.
Right.
And then in a year, it'll be like someone that's driven for 50 years.
Wow.
And then in 2 or 3 years, it'll be like someone that's driven like 400,000 years.
Right.
So it'll be better than the average driver, and then it'll get 10 times better than the top driver. And then it'll get to the point where it'll be like, I think it's not safe for people to drive because it'll be so far advanced.
Yeah. And if, like, every car is self-driving in our world, talking to each other and stuff.
There'll never be any accidents. And then Tesla was coming out with its own insurance, which would be a lot cheaper because the car's never going to get in an accident.
I didn't know that they're doing that.
Yeah, they're already in, like, 6 or 7 states.
Wow.
So I'm just waiting for them to... And then see if you buy one of these and it's full self-driving and you put it on the network, if anything happens, Tesla will cover the accident. Because it'll be such a small amount. Mm. So it's going to be put in like these big insurance companies out of business.
Wow.
And it's going to save like thousands and thousands of lives.
Yeah.
And then if you want to go somewhere, you just say directions to twice the ice on landing.
Give me the ice hookup. Yeah.
So this is my ice plug here.
And I mean, you just know, like, you know all eyes are on you every time you're in this car.
Right.
So I thought that I ran into you a lot before, but now I see you everywhere.
Yeah, this is probably the best marketing tool you could ever... You can't buy that type of advertising because it's the most Googled, most searched, most shared vehicle in the world.
Right.
Probably the most anything like that.
Yeah.
Because there's so few of them. Especially here, because it's like a... Not many people can afford a $100,000 truck. So... And also, too, I ordered it 4.5 years ago.
Right.
So it's not like, if you have the money, you can't just go buy one.
Right.
You know, like, oh, that's cool. I wanted to get one. So, yeah. And then they stopped production for a while. And also, too, it's like there's 2 million orders. And that's worldwide. So it's not like they're going to send 100 of them here. They're going to send like 10 there, 4 there, 5 there.
Right.
When I bought this, they said there was like not even a dozen in Jacksonville.
In all of Jacksonville?
Yeah.
Wow.
And some people are buying them in Jacksonville and taking them out because Jacksonville gets more. So they'll order them here and then take them, like one guy took his to California.
Okay.
So
there's really none in Jacksonville.
There's less than that, you know. And then also too, the people can afford them. They get fingerprints real easily. So nobody wants them to touch them. So they just park in the garage or they don't drive them very much. You know, they don't want anybody to mess with them. So. That makes it even
more rare. Definitely. The first day that you had it at the place, I was like really looking at it. I was like, let me soak it in because this is like the cleanest it will ever look. I know this is going to be fingerprinted up immediately.
So this is my ice plug here. It's vending machine out in the middle of nowhere.
Oh, it's the penguin guy. Yeah. My cousin's friend's dad owns this.
Oh, okay.
I think.
So I'm going to turn this thing around, maybe.
Yep, hello.
All right. See you on the next one.